Hi guys, you're about to watch a preview of my full-length course that's available exclusively on discoverdoublebass.com. So in the next section, we're going to talk about slapping with the bow, and that's actually hitting your bow on the string of your bass. I want to warn you guys that I do that with carbon fiber bow, and this is really my gigging bow, and I take the responsibility to do it. But it will probably not break your bow, but it can harm a little bit the finish of your bow, and so take responsibility and go easy at first to experiment with the different sounds and the different strength at which you can hit your bass in your strings. So let me now give you a few words about what is really, really useful when playing bassline and arco. And those are some little rhythmic things that we can add, and especially the slaps. What I call the slaps is that sound. So if I give you a little example, so I call that slap, but that's probably not a very optimal term, but I think it summarizes really good the sound you want to do and how you want to make it and how you want to make it impact your music. It's just basically the stick of the bow hitting the string, which after that hits the fingerboard. You can have different levels and different sound depending on whether you're playing on the big string or the A or D or even the small G here, which is a little less strong, but it's just basically exactly the same thing as doing that. Sometimes you could want to play a ghost note as well, which is just hitting the string with the hair or playing the string without fingering it on the fingerboard. We'll talk about it later. Just for now, let's start with the basic slap. So it's the same thing than playing PIDs. You do exactly the same thing, except that you do it with the bow. So once you've worked all your bow stroke in all the direction, don't think too much about your bowing while you're bowing, but think about the slap in this case. In that example, all my notes were played pulling. You can do exactly the same thing with all the notes pushed. You can put that slap over another place of the beat. I was playing 2 and 4 here, but you can play them on other beats, for instance the 3. And as the rhythm becomes larger, in this case 1 2 3 4, 1 2 3 4, 1 2 3, and that's the point where we add a few ghost notes to dress up a little bit that bass line. So the skeleton is just 1 2 3 4, 1 2 3. You want to use ghost note maybe on the 4 in this case. 1 2 3 4, 1 2 3 4, 1 2 3 4, 1 2 3. Don't forget to use every direction, even for the ghost note. The ghost note have a bow direction, pull or push. We might want to build a more complex rhythm, so maybe keep the basic afterbeat and downbeat or upbeat and downbeat rule, like have the bass on the downbeat and this treble on the upbeat. So in this case, 2, 3, 4, and add some and add some ghosts over the eighth. So end of one, one and two. And after the two and the four, so we have one, one and two and three and four and in this case, we just play one big bass, but you can start by changing them. And as the ghost notes are played with the exact same movement as the bowed note, this is the same right hand movement as this. You can change and replace a few of the ghost notes which build your rhythmic skeleton. You can change those ghost notes by real notes progressively. For instance, one of the most easy to do is repeat the first note. So it's instead of you'll have. But try to improvise with that and change the notes. So this is a very visible way to play that, but within maybe a 2-4 feel play, it's really nice to add a little bit of slap. For instance, let's get back to a more jazz vibe with a 2-4 playing, like you would play All of Me in 2-4. Maybe. And some few ghosts here and there. Notice that it's with swing 8 in this case. And with even 8. And replacing the ghost by real note. The last device that might really be very useful is to be able to play a slap and at the same time a note. And in this case, the note won't be very powerful. For instance, instead of playing this, or instead of playing this, you'll be playing kind of a mix of both. It's not very powerful per se, but within a bass line, it can help really give some melodic movement. So try to have a note, and in the same time, slap the string. And that's kind of hard to do, but that really adds something melodically. If I take a very basic slapped riff, and if I want a note on the fourth beat, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, and I want that note, and I want the slap in the same time, it will have a really efficient effect rhythmically. Especially if you're making that note sound a little longer than the other. In this case, all our notes are eighth, and the four with the slap on it, I made it a quarter note. And you can experiment with other notes. And And now you can mix all that and just try to play while having a rhythmic skeleton going on behind you. One, two, three. So notice that in the middle of all those syncopation and very short tones, the slurs and the long notes, especially with slides, are really a great thing because they give a lot of roundness to your whole playing. Hey guys, thanks for watching the video. If you want more detail about the course, check the link below.